You know, when I grow up, I hope I can host a show that's only available at a certain time on Facebook.
That'd be amazing.
That would be pretty cool. But right now, this show is actually available anytime after we do it live, because it stays forever. The internet's forever. That fly was not forever. Jimmy just ended it. What'd you do? Jimmy the murderer.
Yeah. It's been bugging us all morning, though.
Bugging us?
She's good.
Do you feel bad? Do you feel bad about what you've done? No remorse?
You know what? Sometimes I do, but there's something hatching now.
Yeah, there's a nest under the desk.
Flies, it's every all over the city. Mm-hmm. I got it in my house. There's those little gnats going around. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mosquitoes.
Speaking of gnats, your microphone's off, by the way.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh. How about
natural sound? Hey,
do you got me now? Can you hear me now?
Just breathe loudly.
Yeah, there's
a call is coming from inside the house.
Gnats? Oh, okay.
What?
You know what? I had some mayonnaise stuck in the back there earlier. Craig.
Really? He's talking to Craig.
What's wrong with you people? Hey, thanks for watching the Today in AZ After Show. I promise it'll only go downhill from here. Mm-hmm. Paul, Vanessa, Mitch, and Jimmy hanging out on the couch. We want to talk to you guys about something that affects every single one of our lives. Liars. If you've ever suspected that your partner might be cheating, it turns out it's all in the face. Mm. According to new research, women are better at hiding it than men.
What?
That study found
not at all surprising.
Men are easier to read when it comes to being unfaithful. This morning, we want to know what you think. How can you tell when someone is lying? Hop in the comment section and let us know.
Women are smarter about it, you know?
Smarter, though? I don't, like, yeah, I mean, actually.
Not that I'm condoning
cheating. Yeah, right. Not like you sound guilty at all.
I think we're
really manipulative good liars. Like, that's not a good quality.
They just think about it. They think about it thoroughly before, like, doing it. So, you know, they're like, okay, I know what he's going to say about this.
Oh, you're saying you're calculated.
Yeah.
Like they've got a plan in place.
Calculating, manipulative, good liars. I don't know. Like, that's not a good quality. I don't know if I'd brag about that.
I'm not bragging about it. I'm just saying. I've heard a lot of stories, and I've
they're called narcissists.
Seen a lot of
psychopaths.
Things happen.
Chronicles of Narcissists.
They believe their laws. Oh, that's a good movie.
Thank you.
Good show.
Yeah.
No, I just think guys are messy about it, so they get caught all the time. You know what I mean? You know your girl's going to check your phone. You know your girl's going to check up on you randomly.
When now, lying in like the 80s
a
is the
random
best,
hour.
You know? I'm sorry, I couldn't get the phone. Bummer.
Yeah, tell us
sorry,
about lying
no
in the
payphones.
Pre-digital age.
My batteries ran out of my my
sorry,
my
I didn't
pager.
Have any dimes on me, right, Jimmy?
You nuts? I couldn't get to a phone. It was a big meeting, I'm telling you. This day and age, I do tell, it does help girls. It's a good litmus test. If the guy's not texting you back throughout the day.
Yeah.
Because guys will do it at first.
Yeah.
They get what they want. They'll text, they'll be there, and then once they're not into you, all of a sudden,
Hold on. You're not 100% wrong on that, but I think there is a caveat. Like, some people, present company included, don't want to be texting all day long. So early in a relationship, maybe you volley the messages back every time, but after a while, that gets old, and it's
how long?
Like, could you kind of leave me alone for
how
a little
long?
Bit? How hot is she?
Exactly.
Wait, you say how hot is she?
But no, yeah. I was joking, but like there's different latitude that you give different people, right? If it's someone I'm really serious about and want to be invested in, obviously I'll put up with something I might not like for a little bit longer. But if it's somebody who I necessarily don't see a future with, then maybe I'll be a little quick with, hey, I'm busy. Or I got stuff to do. I'm not trying to text all day.
Put up with longer?
Oh,
what a grumpy
man. That's why you're single.
What a grumpy man.
But there is something to be said for give me a chance to miss you. You know what I mean?
Yes.
Thank you. Don't just text me all the time because you got to give me a chance to miss you. Because let me sit around and go, oh, you know what? I haven't heard from so-and-so in a while. Let me see what she's up to.
What happens when you marry them? Because then you're going home to them. You have to communicate during the day.
Obviously your behavior changes when you get married.
Right, because you don't have to try anymore, right?
Yeah.
Just mailing it in.
No.
You're stuck with me. There's a contract.
Paul, you have to try extra hard, man. You got to try extra hard.
That's the right answer.
It's the truth, though. Yeah, I've already texted my wife several times this morning. We're in good communication.
Jimmy and his wife talk all the time.
Yeah, they actually do talk.
They FaceTime each other.
They do talk because he talks to text all the time. Do you want to do your impression? Give me your Jimmy texting impression.
Oh, Schnooka, what are you doing? You need to sleep good this morning.
That's good.
Go poopy. Rusko's their dog.
Period. Yeah, he has to put the punctuation in.
Do Rusko go poopy?
Period.
Can't wait to get home.
Jimmy, is that true? I have not witnessed this.
Yeah, if you've ever seen the movie Forces of Nature with Ben Affleck, he's on the plane and the guy's next to him listening to him go talk to his girlfriend. Ben Affleck's going, no. I love you. I love you. So yeah, we're codependent on each other.
That's good.
But
and I think codependency. FaceTime.
Like they just left each other so many hours ago, and then you guys are like FaceTiming each other, and I see them, and I'm like, and then he'll do it sometimes during the break, you know, and so he'll be like, hi, Honey.
Oh, that's sweet.
It is cute.
Emma checks on her kids during the show. You know what
True.
I mean?
Like, she does that's, it on a video.
When you love somebody, Jimmy, you don't want to be apart from them.
I think if you're both, it doesn't matter, as long as you're both the same level.
Yes.
If you both like that, if true love to use texting once a day and she feels the same way, that works.
Yeah.
You know, for us, it's 80 times a day. It's a lot of FaceTime.
So when you're into a girl.
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
Texting's
it's all
problem,
about how much
right?
you're
like,
into
you're just
it.
Like, you keep going and going. So does
not
it like
necessarily
eventually
about
wear
how
off
hot
for
she
you?
Is.
Like
no,
after
it's not
six
that it,
months?
It's not that it wears off. It's that texting specifically becomes a burden, I think, to some of us. Because it's something you have to do. You feel an obligation to get to it. And once you start feeling the obligation, it kind of loses its purpose. Like, the reason I want to talk to that person is because I thoroughly enjoy speaking to them. And I enjoy exchanging ideas or updating about my day or making plans for the future. But when it starts to feel like, God, I gotta get to these texts. I got 14 missed texts.
You gotta start scheduling them.
Right. It's like, well, I gotta find 5 minutes to respond. And then then it stresses you out and you don't want to talk to that person anymore. Like, that's where I think it becomes a task.
Yeah.
Let's get back to the line.
Well, that's my point.
This explains a lot.
This explains it. So when the texts start slowing down, and then she starts questioning you. Are you cheating? Are you lying to me? Are you doing something
Why
else?
Is she questioning me? What evidence have I given her to any of that?
Because your interaction with her has changed. So she's like, well, is he not into me anymore? Is he talking to someone else? Is he lying to me? Those are the questions that are going to go through her head after you start
Let me answer your question with a question. When you're texting a guy, what are you talking about?
Random stuff. How's your day? What's going on? What are we going to do later?
Right.
Thinking about you.
If you had texted a guy for a year, let's say straight.
Right.
Not consecutively, you took time to sleep and eat.
Weird.
But too much. So you texted him for a year. Mm-hmm. Are you still texting him as much in that second year about that same stuff? Because eventually you've crossed all the bridges. You've talked about all the things. There's no more politics or religion to text about. It's just like, what are you doing now and what are you doing later? Those are the only topics, right? Or look at this funny thing I found online.
Right. I don't know. I feel like in my past relationships that we continue to text the same unless something changed.
Unless
he lost interest, if there was someone else involved in the picture, then that's when our habits change.
So in a very roundabout way, you're saying a decrease in text activity is a sure sign that somebody's up to something no good.
In my past experiences, would you agree? And that would go back to lying, right? Because she's going to ask you.
No, there's definitely something going on if it's a change. Now, if it's consistent, whether it's like a lot or a little, whether it's consistent, that's a big deal.
That's what Jimmy was saying.
I'm sure Jimmy can tell you as he texts his wife. that you know, when you're with somebody, when you're in love, when you're married, man, you don't like run out of interest. You're not like, oh well, today, you know, I stopped being interested in what you're doing today. You're like, hey, what are you doing right now? What are you doing? You want to talk to me?
Baby, they're making fun of me on the after show.
Paul, I texted you one time and you gave me the is everything okay? And I was like, okay, Paul doesn't want to hear from me.
No, it's not you specifically. Is there a problem here?
Yeah, I was like, hey, man, how's everything going?
I know when they don't want to talk to you.
He's like, everything's fine. Is everything okay?
do you know what they do when they don't want to talk to you? You get this back.
The thumbs up.
Especially when you're like, hey, Paul, just got done doing golf. This course is amazing. It's great. Hey, when's the last time you go golf? We got to get together.
Thumbs up.
Yeah, like, I'm good, I'm over it.
My grandma does that. She'll slap the emoji.
Well, we were supposed to be talking about lying.
No, what is that? That's in regards to lying. But listen, this is another move that Laura Jonas shared with us. Phones facing down is a player move.
Yeah. The face down
yeah,
phone.
Yeah, so you don't see who's texting or 100%. What's coming through.
Okay, can I be honest? And I know that my wife could be watching, or her dad, who I love to death. He's like my dad now.
Love you, Dad.
It is down for kind of that reason. And that's every now and then some lame-o ex from way in the past
comes kicking tires.
Comes kicking tires, flying around, that might even know that I'm married and happily married, but says
and
some snarky
married.
Little thing. Of course, I'll get if I could be on a desert island, none of them will ever call. But if I'm on the couch with her, I'm like, hey, honey, all of a sudden it pops.
Who's Lindsay?
Lindsay.
That's happened to me before.
It's happened to all
I'm like, show you text, I'm like, wow.
You do the quick swipe up, and that's not obvious at all, right? I'm not hiding anything. I always swipe notifications up super fast.
I'm the opposite. I put mine face down so that I don't look at who texted me, because I will. Okay. If we're at dinner or something, I'll look at it and be like, oh, I should respond to that. And like, my wife is, it's a big fight over like how much I have my phone in my hand and whether or not I'm responding. So if I put it face down, it's not because I don't want her to see see it. It's because I don't want to look at it. Because otherwise, I'm going to be like, oh, what was that?
I mean, I think there are lots of reasons for leaving the phone face down. Yeah. But some of them are indeed a little shady. Like, and just in general, like, if Vanessa was telling me, texting me bad things about Jimmy, and Jimmy's around me, I don't want him to see me get the alert that's like, Jimmy,
nor do
today.
I
you
want,
I mean?
Nor do I want to see.
No, nobody wants Jimmy to see that.
My wife says the same thing. In true trust, she trusts me, and she knows that this will happen. She says, just turn it down.
Yeah.
I don't want to see it.
Right.
So just you deal with it, and so she's cool with me turning it down too. It's not like, you know.
I don't know. Like, I guess in times when I'm barely dating someone, I will leave it up anyway, because I'm like, if somebody's texting me, like, it's not, you're not in the position to, like, question me, or if a dude's name does pop up on there.
Yeah, but
like,
if it's the love of your life, this is the dude that hits every check on your list, you're going to really care when Joe Blow, Jack Wagon Bob's, hey, Jack what's Wagon going Bob. On? Exactly. And this guy knows who Bob is.
Okay.
You got it, freaking, what the hell, what's he want? And then you blow it off, oh, he's just calling, and it starts creating a riff. Uh-huh. Then you either block Bob or you do something, because, when you meet the guy of your dreams, you will care.
Let me say this. Okay. Leaving the phone face up is a power move. As much as keeping it face down might be a shady move, if you're confident enough, it's kind of like the heavier guy that goes shirtless at the pool. Pal, if you're down showing off the goods, and you know that you're not embarrassed by it, if you're not embarrassed by what's coming up on your phone and you want to leave it like this, bravo, sir. Power move. Let's get to some of your responses before we scare everybody off.
Okay.
Eileen is not trustworthy of men at all. She says she knows he's lying if his mouth is open.
Aha, that's great. Okay, so I love this one, and I just heard this the other day on the radio. So Lacey Dickens says it gives way too many unnecessary details. I was listening to the radio the other day, and
overselling.
They said, yes.
That's what Amanda says.
Yes, when the guy or the person talks way too much, gives you too many details, it's because they're lying to you.
Right. What'd you do this afternoon?
Yeah.
Oh, I went over to lunch to that new sandwich joint, and I ordered a number 5, and you know they always put tomato on the sandwiches there. I was like, please don't put tomato on the sandwich. She gives me the sandwich. I go back. I take a bite. It's full of tomato. Yes. So I end up taking it back to her. I didn't even get to eat the sandwich. I walked right out. So I'm still hungry if you want to get something.
And you know what my reaction would be? Who did you eat lunch with?
Yeah, right. Oh, nobody. You know I like to go by myself. I don't like eating in front of people, right, babe?
So wait, that's a sign of lying? Because I feel like that's something people do to disguise the fact that they're lying, and a lot of times
try to give too many details.
Like verisimilitude. I've got all the details in here, and I wouldn't possibly make all these things up, because that would be psychopathic.
Right. And I'm not a psychopath,
I'm
right?
I'm totally
not
a psychopath.
Psycho. let me see. Sherry said, lying people usually cannot look directly in your face, avoiding eye contact.
Yeah, eye contact's always a big one, right? That's what they tell you at poker school, is the people that can't look at you right in the eye are up to something.
I like this one, too. Nicholas Kelly, narcissistic individuals believe in lying is truth. It just reminds me of George Costanza. It's not a lie if you believe it.
Yeah, that's sociopath. My best friend, who's like my brother to me, Vince Linden in Colorado, he's an attorney. Ever since we were kids, he says, you lie because I say this one thing. So he'll say, hey, dude, did you take my beers? And I'd be like, huh? It was always that.
What?
Yeah. And he said, yeah, you're lying.
So you're not lying, but you're not telling the truth.
No, I didn't do it. Huh? No, you did, because you said that thing again.
It's just it's like a means to buy time.
Yeah, I'm trying to like
anyway, that manifests itself, right? Where you're like, I'm sorry, I didn't hear you? Or can you rephrase the question? Or, I don't know what you mean.
Pardon me?
You're just buying yourself a chance to come up with an excuse.
We have this is sad, because Maria says, good morning, lying. If my ex was talking, he was lying. And then I'm not too sure how to pronounce his name.
Let's go Michael.
Michael, assume everyone is lying, then you're good.
Yeah. Don't believe anyone. That's not jaded at all.
Oh, my God.
Michael says, another Michael, when you're the only two in the room and an invisible skunk walks in, how bad is that?
You're like...
Or like when you're in the elevator and you can't wait till you get upstairs and then somebody gets in the floor before you and it's like, this elevator just smells like farts. It's not me, man. Weird. I don't know.
Or booze. That happens.
Side note.
10 o'clock in the morning.
Side note, our newsroom is 7 floors up and we all have to use the elevator.
Oh, yeah. True.
That's a good thing. Yeah, so we're always in there.
True experience.
I've smelled booze.
I've smelled marijuana. I've smelled that as well.
The devil's grass.
Marijuana.
Hayden says, keep an eye for touching the face. Anybody that's doing a lot of this. They say psychologists will tell you that people that touch their face a lot because they're trying to hide their expressions. And they don't know what to do with their hands, because when you're nervous, you do a whole lot of fidgeting. And so if you're touching your face, that's like a sure sign that...
Have any of you guys ever been deposed? I had to be...
Deposed?
Yeah.
I thought you were describing like a bar in Scottsdale.
Yeah.
Have you been deposed?
I had to go through a deposition.
Really?
It was a big lawsuit.
This sounds like a story to me. Doesn't this sound like a story?
Corporate America... Let's hear it.
Story time for Jimmy's deposition. Let's go.
The names, faces, and places have been changed to protect the innocent.
Tonight, I Unsolved Mysteries.
But it's only coincidence if you recognize this story.
Right.
I had a friend that was involved in a lawsuit.
Can we use names? Can we make
remember
names
that time
up?
I got
yeah,
sued?
Absolutely. Okay. Suzanne.
Okay.
Suzanne was in the middle of a lawsuit. I worked with Suzanne. I had privy to a lot of knowledge as to what was going on.
Sure.
So the corporation thought I could help them. So they spent money. They flew me to a city, especially Cincinnati.
Let's call it Cincinnati.
They flew me to Cincinnati.
The lovely Cincinnati.
Oh, it's gorgeous.
Ohio.
Oh, so in the fall, beautiful.
Yeah. Queen City.
So don't we get into Cincinnati, and they take me to this building, and I walk in, and I see all these friendly faces, of guys that look like you, only not
that's
friendly.
That's supposed to be Jimmy.
Very well put together suits, like you make a lot of money.
Let's call them Match
yeah.
and Raul.
Let's call them that. Yeah, exactly. Raul is the leader. Raul is the leader. And Match was like, so they all sit there, and in the middle of this deposition, they start, you know, hammering me. Well, first they realized they thought I was on their side.
Oh.
When I wasn't on anyone's side, I was there to tell the truth.
Yes, but
when they realized that the truth I was giving them wasn't what they liked,
wasn't the truth they
turned
wanted.
On me.
Yeah.
They match, and especially Raul.
Raul.
Extremely. So I felt like I wasn't lying, but holy crap, I felt like these guys couldn't ask me if I had a glass of milk, and like I felt like they were, you liar. I'm like, I did. Would you for breakfast? Bacon?
And
yeah,
then, and
yeah but you had yeah, potatoes earlier. You didn't say that. Oh. So that was the craziest thing. I couldn't have, people that are professionals
yeah.
on how to get people to lie, they wear you down.
I have found that in contract negotiations too. People that are professionals at I guess it's any specific thing like that involves negotiation or involves getting you to say something they want you to say. The people that get paid to do that are pretty darn good at it.
Practice.
Before you know it, you're singing like a bird and you're like, oh, wow, what did I just do?
Yeah.
And they soften you up with questions where you won't lie. That's
right.
A good one out there for folks out there. If you want
pro
to see
tip, if you want to lie and get away with
soften
it.
Soften them up. So what was Detroit like? You're from that's
oh,
awesome.
Yeah, I love it, man. It's great in the fall. Yeah. Way better than Cincinnati.
Beautiful. Where'd you get the shoes?
Oh Men's Warehouse. I won't buy this brand again,
those
though, because they scuff.
But yeah. You said you don't like to go to the malls. You told us that earlier.
Yeah.
So how would you...
So where
Men's
you get
Warehouse
from?
Is only
well,
at
sometimes
the malls.
I go. I have to go if I...
Lie. Softened them up. Then you hit them. Pow.
Got me.
Okay,
what did you know and when did you know it?
I like this. Stephanie asked us a question. She said, how many times do you think you lie each day? And what's the most common topic you lie about?
Smart.
To protect the innocent.
I lie to protect people.
You know, I
lie to protect people and their emotions and their feelings. I think that's a responsible human thing to do.
Yeah.
Maybe that's not a popular opinion to say, but sometimes you have to bend the truth a little bit so that people don't hate you.
Yeah.
Or people don't, or that you're just like, withholding information is a form of lying, right? Mm-hmm. But you have to, because if I told you everything that was going on in my head, that would
everybody
be bad for
would
everyone.
Hate you.
Yeah, well, I lie at my job to be nice to my
sure.
coworkers.
Right, of course.
But it's not necessarily just this job. That's every job.
Yeah.
You're going to come into contact with people in your day who you do not like, who you do not want to talk to, but you're going to see them every day. So you got to be nice to them, and you got to say nice things, and you lie.
That's called playing in the sandbox. And sometimes, you know.
And I mean, again, it isn't specific to this place. I'm too new to really hate anybody here, but like, it's just... You're going to find people you don't like, and you're going to say lies to that you get along with them.
And speaking of people that Mitch doesn't like, he had to sit next to one this morning on Today in AZ. In case you missed the show, it was a little different. For the first time in my tenure here, we had two guys on the desk. Paul Gerke alongside Mitch Carr stepping in for Emma Jade. You're watching The Bro Show. Just a couple of dudes doing the news. JQ's here, too. Big Game of Thrones
fan. He's a bro.
Yeah. What are you doing?
I'm just taking the jacket off. I'm with the guys.
Just hanging out with the guys. It's a power
stance. Why do you have your hand in your belt?
Don't you ever do that? Hanging out, watching the baseball game? Hey, Paul, we gotta
put your feet up, just hanging out a little bit.
Paul, we gotta toughen this guy up. You know what? The manicure has got to go.
I've been punching him in the commercial breaks. It's like it's a hazing
thing. I think he's from New York City or something like that. I don't know. He's very refined. Very refined.
What was this?
Yeah, we're still doing it.
What is that?
Hey, just sit in front of the TV. Yeah, the boob tube. That's what we used to call back in our day. And you just get the remote.
He's pulling an Al Bundy, but not really.
Yeah.
That is kind of an Al Bundy.
Yeah, see, I think I was saying to Paul, I think he looks more like Zach Galifianakis from The Hangover.
Yeah. A little bit.
Waiting there.
I'll take both of those as a compliment.
I will say it's been fun working with all you fellas today.
Yeah, you're outnumbered today.
You're a commodity.
Yeah, it was great.
You're a commodity when there's tons of ladies around.
It's like San Francisco in here. It's
Man
Francisco, they call it. And it's like seven men for every three women or something like that. And Man Jose,
and
it's the same thing.
San Diego.
Denver.
All right, guys, we got to get to our juicy question of the morning because we didn't get a chance to pay it off this morning because we had a special report. So here it is. Over half of people wish they could go back in time and change this. We received tons of text messages. People were saying marriages, your name.
Yes.
What were
college
some
majors.
College majors. Okay, and here is the answer.
It was college
majors. College
majors. I only remember the right answer. I'm sorry.
I know. I was like, you just gave it away.
Sorry.
Someone did guess that and guess correctly.
Yeah, they did.
I took the easiest degree that I could possibly get. Which
Don't
was
say that because I have the same
which
one.
Which is communications journalism. Because I couldn't pass anything else. Yeah.
I double majored. Spanish and broadcast journalism.
That's okay. This dude, this gringo here, he can speak fluent like the natives. Very good.
See, you'll play Mind the Mail email.
A couple more tips from the people before we say goodbye. Jennifer, saying the word honestly. And you're like, honestly, I did this. Honestly.
That's not honesty.
Great point there.
To be honest with you.
Dead giveaway.
Amy Nico says everyone's different. Body language doesn't mean anything. We have five kids. Each one lies differently. The youngest is 11. She gets defensive when she lies, like really defensive, and she doesn't realize she's doing it. Don't tell her.
That's pretty good.
And don't let her watch the show because we'll give it away. All right. Producer Alyssa says we have to wrap. As much as this conversation has legs, in my opinion. We're getting the wrap. Same place, same time tomorrow, 7:30 on the couch.
Let's do it, guys.
Thanks for watching.
See you in the Man Show tomorrow.
See you tomorrow. It'll be Friday.
Check the Twitters. See what's going on out there. See what's going on in the sports.
Is it the right side?
What's going on in the sports world out there?
I need to step out of this real quick.
It's not supposed to be the side, but...